Hey everybody, Will Davis, Realtor, coming back to you from Calford Realty and Design. And today I wanted to talk about how do we know if it's a buyer or a seller's market? You've probably heard a lot on the news or on the radio about home sales and how it's hard to get a home right now and how prices are high. But what are some indicators that tell us that aside from just somebody going, hey, let's all make houses expensive? Well, one way we do that is about inventory. So basic principles of economics. If there's a lot of something, it becomes less expensive because there's plenty of it. And the opposite is also true. If there aren't many things of an item, there aren't many diamonds, so diamonds become more expensive. Well, houses are the exact same way, but as houses don't come and go, it's more about what's available on the market, what's for sale. And we use an indicator of inventory over months. And so we'll say a 6 month inventory of houses. Right now, if we pause time on how many houses are for sale, how long would it take for those houses to sell normally? Well, 6 months is average. So if we pause today, would we have enough houses for 6 months worth of buyers? Well, no, we wouldn't. We're not even close. The numbers came out for July, and in July, 1.4 months worth of inventory. Six is average. More than six would be kind of a buyer's market. Houses would lose some value. Under six, houses become more expensive because there aren't as many of them. We're not at six or five or four or three or two. We're at 1.4. So that's one of the ways that we figure out how housing prices are going to be. So if you're ever curious and you want to know, hey, what's our inventory on houses? Because I'm thinking about buying or I'm thinking about selling. Reach out. We're happy to let you know. Let me know. Send me a DM, send me a message. Anyway, that's what I got for you today. Hope you're having a great week. Thanks so much.